Yes, I'm pressing the button, but it's not broadcasting. That green light is supposed to be red.
Which light?
This one here. Donna's grandson wrote down instructions for me, but I can't for the life of me remember where I put them.
You sure you're not on the air?
Yeah, green means off, red means on. Or was it? No, that's right. I need a red light here.
Oh, have you tried just mashing all these buttons?
Oh, raspberries. That's... Which button did you press?
This one right here. Nope, that wasn't it.
I'm gonna call Donna's grandson.
Hello?
Tapio? Sorry, I misdialed.
No, you didn't. I was still on the line.
Can we get Tapio off the line? I need to call Donna's grandson.
Wrong. That was the Anderson girl. Different girl.
No. That girl drowned in Cauldron Lake.
Must be all this rain botching up your connection. If it keeps up, that bunker out back could flood again. A girl drowned in that bunker last time it flooded.
Can we please focus on making the green light red?
What about this button here with the sticky note that says on-off?
Yes, that's the one. Okay, let's press that and see if it... You can pick up those crochet dog sweaters at the Sunday market. And while you're there, go visit Wendy Davis and grab some of our sponsor's famous beef jerky. Up next, we've got Deer Fest. Oh, hold on now. We have a call coming in. Which button is that? Hello?
Hello. Still here.
Wrong line. Hold on. Hello. Hello. You're on with Pat Main.
Yeah. Gil Davis here.
What a pleasant surprise. We have Gil Davis on the line from our lovely sponsor, Davis Family Beef Jerky. Gil, any thoughts on those crochet dog sweaters?
You need to stop.
What's that?
Just stop. Whatever this is you're doing, stop.
Well, I'm not sure I understand, Gil.
There's no such thing as Davis Family Beef Jerky. I don't sell beef jerky. I've never made beef jerky. I don't particularly like beef jerky. I'm getting crazy phone calls for jerky orders, day and night. You got confused old ladies all over this goddamn town on the hunt for imaginary beef jerky, asking for insane flavors like hickory teriyaki, which clearly isn't a thing.
If you don't sell beef jerky, then somebody needs to tell your lovely wife, Wendy, because she's out there at the market every Sunday selling it.
Wendy is dead, Pat.
No, that's not right. I just saw Wendy at the market last weekend.
Wendy went missing.
Another one of those cult boxes.
that main radio hour. Up next, it's time to make some predictions on what parade floats we'll be seeing at Deerfest. This year's parade theme is deer, just like every year. So. But first, I need to address something. I know the last couple of shows took a strange turn.
Right. Oh, this darn carnival of music. Shadows shifted in the dark!
Where'd it go?
I'm coming right up!
Ah!
general store.
Another cult stash, another cult box.
When Cynthia Weaver was downstairs at breakfast, Rose snuck into her room. With all the lamps in the room, it took her a while to find the one with an angel. Luckily, the dream Alan had sent her had been very clear. Rose was certain that Cynthia would not miss one lamp. She had so many. Tonight, Rose would put the lamp in a shoebox and let it sink into the garden pond. That's what Alan wanted. That's how she could help him. The thought made her whole body buzz with joy. Cynthia knew the lamp was missing the very moment she came back to her room. She was overcome by grief. It had been Tom's lamp, one of the few things that reminded her of him. It had not worked in a long time with the cord severed and the light switch gone. But there are other kinds of lights than the ones we can see. The invisible light of the angel lamp had held Cynthia together all these years. With tears welling in her eyes, she didn't see the shadows shifting in the corners of her room.
another rhyme. They're all so soft and sad.
Thank you.
No. Sure. I'm getting quite the charm collection. Another locked box. more of those rhymes. Another Alex Casey lunchbox? Right.
Townsfolk were anxious.
Yeah.
In one fluid motion, Saga cracked open the shotgun, sending the empty hulls flying over her shoulder, and slammed the new shells in faster than she had imagined possible.
Streets.
Rex, it's time to make some predictions on what parade lights we'll be seeing again.
More of those kids' lunchboxes. Another rhyme. Okay.
bleeding! Overgrown! modest, rustic charm!
Another charm. I can't get through this.
Those people just burst in here and expect others to clean up after them.
There's another cult stash.
She wouldn't just wander off and not tell us. Not opening. Remember how it went last time? The sacrifices we made? Pain. It's happening again. We learned from the last time, didn't we? Fought our way through it, held fast. And now look at us, as thick as thieves.
exits.
Another one of those cult boxes.
We'll be seeing a deer fest. This year's parade theme is deer, just like every year, so we're not exactly reinventing the wheel here. But first, I need to address something. I know the last couple of shows took a strange turn, with people coming on away. Listen, I know everybody who steps foot in and out of this town.
Out. Always a good sign. There's Taken inside. Anyone here?
I'm here, in the closet.
Agent Estevez? Is that you?
Anderson? You want me to tell you to fuck off?
Looks like it's a good thing I didn't.
Looks like. My leg's busted, and I need your help. Listen, there is a person out there with you invaded by something.
Estevez. That leg doesn't look good.
Feels even worse. But thanks for saving the rest of me. We should talk.
What happened here?
Where to fucking start? We came to check out a system alert at Cauldron Lake, but it's worse than we could handle. Real boondoggle. The police, my own agents, most were invaded before we could even react.
Have you found my partner, Agent Casey?
Yeah, we found him. Out in the woods. He had a close encounter with the Shadow, and it did something to him.
Is he okay?
He's alive. We took him down to the morgue for an examination. Haven't heard anything since the attack.
What did the FBC come here to do?
Bright Falls is the site of a recurring altered world event. The Shadow is stronger than we expected. We're low on resources. Problems at HQ. But we do have equipment for dealing with the shaded threat. We were just caught off guard before we could set it up.
Where is Wake? I know what's going on here. Wake can fix this.
Alan Wake is a para-utilitarian. The word's a mouthful, so you know it's serious. We have him locked up in the holding cells per protocol. He's connected to the Shadow in some way.
Estevez, I need to see Wake. How do I get into the cell block?
Okay. Protocols don't mean that much at this point anyway. Don't make me regret this, Anderson. Until the power's back on, the door to the holding cells won't open. There's a fuse box downstairs in the basement. Here. You'll need these keys.
Back into the morgue, huh? Fantastic. The cell door won't open without power. Thank you. I'm sure Sheriff Breaker wouldn't mind me borrowing this.
Read me, Anderson.
I read you. Have you had Alf frequency this entire time?
Eavesdropping is a big part of the job. But no, I got it from your partner. Anderson, look for a fuse to replace the blown out one in the fuse box. That should get the power going again.
Yeah. On it. Another cult stash?
Anderson. Like what I've done with the place.
Could use a bit more light.
Funny.
Stay put, Casey. I'll let you know when it's safe. How are you holding up?
Don't give me that worried look, Anderson. It's a flesh wound. Gave me a chance to have a nice chat about ex-wives with Kieran. Agent Estevez, I mean.
Making new friends, huh? I'm jealous. Are you sure you're okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. What's the situation on your end?
What happened at the hotel?
𝗔𝗞 was telling the truth about the cult being after him. That thing, the dark presence, it's real too. I saw it. A fucked up monster cloud. 𝗔𝗞 tried to warn me. It knocked me out. FBC found me in the woods later.
Watery turned out to be a good lead. Found the clicker and the cult. But the horror story is changing reality. Like 𝗔𝗞 said it would. Logan, the story claims she died here. But we can stop it.
Wait, Saga. What do you, Logan is gone. She has been. For a long time.
Casey's affected by the horror story, too. I'm fighting for them all now. I'm gonna fix this, Casey. You, Logan, all of it. I just need to get the power back on first.
Yeah, give them hell, Anderson. Just remember, some things in life can't be fixed with a light switch. As for the power problem, here. I found a fuse on those poor bastards there.
I'll take care of it.
Anderson, good news, bad news. You can get to the cell block now, but the shaded hostiles that were in there are on the loose.
Thanks for the heads up. Situation is under control, Estevez. Coming back up.
Copy.
Over here. Behind the counter.
Got a little cramped in that closet.
Is the FBC sending any help?
We were the help. Well, us in the lake house. But we still have bureau gear specifically engineered to fight this threat. It's stored in the back lot. We were setting it up when the Taken interrupted us. We have light arrays, a containment cell, etc., etc. We are not out of this fight yet.
What's going on?
We had a hell of a time avoiding those Taken. Ended up back here. Anyway, I wanted to warn you that we have the Koskula brothers in the cells as well. They're the ringleaders of the Cult of the Tree. Don't let your guard down.
What's at the lake house?
It's a bureau research facility at Cauldron Lake set up to study the effects of this AWE. When I got into town, I went there for backup. The whole station is lost, taken by the Shadow. Lost a lot of agents. Barely got out myself.
Wish me luck.
According to the Luck and Probability Department, it's statistically bad luck to wish people good luck during a crisis.
Thanks. An electrical lock system with no failsafe. Smart. Something is wrong. What's happening to Casey?
I'm a goner. Swell. A shadow crawling under my skin. In my head. Call my ex. Tell her I'm sorry. Terminal case, Casey.
Something is wrong with him. He's hurt worse than he says. He's scared.
Fucking FBI, FBC, you government fucks all fucking this up for us! Let us the fuck out!
You're the leaders of the cult. You're not going anywhere.
Wait, we'll ruin everything! Get rid of him, 𝗔𝗟! You fucking shot me! Typical government stooge. Let me out so I can kill him, that fucker! You come to our town and act like you know what you're dealing with, but you have no fucking idea! Let us out! You can't stop it, none of you can. We can take care of this. We've been preparing for this.
𝗔𝗟, do you have it?
You wrote Logan into the story. You told me yourself, from the dark place.
Listen, Scratch is coming. He's close. He's almost here.
My daughter is dead because of you. She's a child. What the fuck is wrong with you?
I'm trying to fix this. I will fix this. I'll save everyone, but we're running out of time. I need the clicker.
I have the clicker. You will fix this. You will save my daughter. Promise me.
Yes, I promise. But we're out of time. Hurry!
Give it to him! He's a fucking monster, �𝗎! There it is! We've been waiting for you, motherfucker! I'm gonna fucking destroy you!
Scratch is here. How do I stop him?
Bad news. The containment unit is in progress.
trapped, but the light array should affect him.
These need to power the light array. Need to find more. Too fast.
Right.
scratches wakes double. He tricked us. He almost got the clicker from me. The whole plan has gone out the window. How could we get this so wrong?
Textbook boondoggle.
You said it, Anderson. It's a shit show. So what's the plan?
Scratch pretended to be Wake to trick us.
He almost won me over. I should have trusted my gut. I had a bad feeling about him when we found him at the lake. When that insane monster cloud came at me in the woods, I saw a face inside it. Wake's. I think he was always a monster. Always Scratch.
Scratch was pretending to be Wake. Manipulating me. What does he want from me? No. I'm in control here. It's my mind place. He's powerful. Too powerful. Just his presence here makes me feel sick. Like a wave of terror through my head. I feel his single-minded drive to get the clicker.
Agent Young held his clipboard up to the light. The equipment was all accounted for. He ticked the boxes, satisfied. A noise on the other side of the back lot made him pause. He peered into the darkness. Nothing. Shrugging, he signed and dated the form. Estevez wanted everything ready, just in case. Young appreciated a cautious leader. Estevez had held it together even after the oldest house had gone dark. Young began to head inside. The local sheriff's station was a tight fit, but at least they had a coffee machine. Young felt optimistic. They even had the para-utilitarian in custody already. Another clatter behind him. Closer this time. He turned, hand on his holster. He called out to the darkness.
This station has been seized by the Federal Bureau of Control. You're not authorized to be here.
Suddenly, the lights flickered, went off. Young couldn't see a thing. Then from inside the station, the screams began.
I assumed Wake escaped the dark place. Is it possible he's still there?
The Big Apple in an ocean of darkness. Gone diving. Note from my editor. You're using the wrong tense. Trapped in a loop. My friends will meet him when I'm gone.
Wake is still trapped in the dark place. Maybe he always was.
Three remaining.
The FBC usually handles stuff like this, right? Any thoughts?
Hold up. You brought a paranormal object in here without telling me and then almost handed it over to a hostile entity?
I didn't know if I could trust you. That was a mistake. So was believing Scratch. But it's not too late. I just need to understand more.
You got that right. Let's start acting like we're on the same side, yeah?
The horror story is changing reality. It made it so my daughter died here, even though she's supposed to be back home in Virginia. Do you know if that's...
AWEs are localized distortions of reality. The area outside town might not be affected. Sometimes they expand, sometimes they fizzle out. If we can make sure it's the latter, your kid might be fine.
The whole thing is a nightmare. I can't let my family be torn apart.
Having family isn't easy in this line of work. The late nights, travel, alternate realities threatening their existence. My ex-wife couldn't take it.
Karen, you're better off without her. I know I am.
So tell me what I'm missing. The FBC must know something.
Good news, we have Bureau intel on all of this. Bad news, it's highly classified. Good news, consider yourself deputized into the Federal Bureau of Control. Here's a key to the cell where we keep the files. Happy reading.
Okay. Thanks. Go team. You really don't remember Logan living in Virginia with me and David?
I remember you and David having problems. You needed a break. You and Logan moved to Watery and then Logan... Well, that awful thing happened. After you came back to work, I thought you'd be the perfect partner for this case. If you were willing to return to the area.
Okay. That's enough. The story is changing your memories. What you're remembering is fiction. Logan is alive. I'm not divorced. We never moved here. I remember the truth.
No. Wake or Scratch, whoever that was, said the story could be used to attack us. We all need to question what's real. With that said, how do we know the story isn't giving you false hope?
I can't convince them. I just need to change the story.
This is the kind of case my ex hated. No one's my
fault. I'm sorry about your brother, Elmo.
'Yuk was all heart. He always went along with my ideas, no matter how stupid they were. Always happy to help. I got carried away. I never think things through. It's my fault.
I realize it's a bad time. But I need you to tell me everything about the cult of the tree.
The cult is my craziest idea that ever worked. Look, what kind of a cult calls themselves a cult? Exactly. We protect Watery and Bright Falls. We're the good guys. A secret neighborhood watch. That was the idea, anyways. Look, we've always known about the horror inside the lake. When any Taken come out, we kill them.
You don't turn people into Taken. You kill the ones who already have. How long has the cult been around for?
Certain folks around here have always known about Cauldron Lake. Before us, it was the Torchbearers. And when I inherited the mission, I wanted to call it a cult. It was genius. Just named it half the work. Made people too scared to go into the woods at night. Business 101. Fear is a great motivator.
You were trying to kill Alan Wake. Why?
Nothing good has ever come out of Cauldron Lake. The nightmare that hit Bright Falls in 2010 was all because of his writing. And ever since then, pages of his stories are floating up from the lake, and monsters keep popping out. It's all him, Wake. And if we don't stop him, no one will.
Wake's evil doppelganger Scratch is the threat we're facing, not Wake. And I will stop him.
I've never heard of anyone called Scratch.
Wake is trapped in the dark place. He's been reaching out, communicating with me in the overlaps.
Hmm.
Nah. The dark presence is vulnerable against bright light. At least that makes sense. Ilmo said the cult kills Taken. Is he telling the truth?
Surplus deer masks buy in bulk. We've got a floater, a Taken on the shore. Call the gang Yakko. We are going hunting. Cult of the tree. Keeping the town safe since 2013.
Ilmo is telling the truth about the cult. They really were fighting the Taken. We're on the same side. If the cult is killing Taken, then why did Nightingale target the one?
Private party. Invitation only. Wrong time. Wrong place. Time to go, Yakko. A job half done isn't done at all.
Nightingale became a Taken because the Bookers interrupted their ritual. I'm gonna deal with the situation, Ilmo. But the town will need protection until we sort this out. I could use your help.
Right. Right. I'll round up the gang. Whoever's left. We won't let these fucking monsters hurt any more of our people. We'll do my brother proud.
Thank you, Ilmo. So the cult of the tree actually kills Taken. They were on our side, even if their methods are misguided and criminal.
It looked right from where we were standing. Nothing's what it seems in this case. Too many stories contradicting each other. Too many versions of the truth.
We have a lot of catching up to do after this thing is all over. Everything is different now. My family. Me? The whole fucking world.
I'll buy the coffee, Anderson. Partners to the end. This case is one for the books.
I see what you did there.
That's funny. Cases that might kill me were my ex's favorite.
Wake isn't the first person the Dark Presence disguised itself as. as a gateway to the dark place. What the hell is a para-utilitarian? The clicker amplifies any changes to reality suggested by a piece of art. Makes them permanent. I need to know what information I can still trust.
Rose woke up from another dream from her idol, another message. All through her morning routine, she was humming happily. So happily, she realized she was starting to forget what Alan had told her. Something about a hero who would come to save them all. And the hero. Rose frowned. This won't do, Rose Marigold. You know better than to forget. Something about knitwear. The hero liked it? Rose nodded, determined. She'd use the network to guide the hero to the secret stashes she had hid in the forest to help them. Knitwear to mark the spot. Alan will love that, she thought. Now she only needed the network. Rose thought hard. Mandy May was always knitting. Mandy May would help her. Agent Young held his clipboard up to the light. The equipment was all accounted for. He ticked the boxes, satisfied. A noise on the other side of the back lot made him pause. He peered into the darkness. Nothing. Shrugging, he signed and dated the form. Estevez wanted everything ready, just in case. Young appreciated a cautious leader. Estevez had held it together even after the oldest house had gone dark. Young began to head inside. The local sheriff's station was a tight fit, but at least they had a coffee machine. Young felt optimistic. They even had the para-utilitarian in custody already. Another clatter behind him. Closer this time. He turned, hand on his holster. He called out to the darkness.
This station has been seized by the Federal Bureau of Control. You're not authorized to be here.
Suddenly, the lights flickered, went off. Young couldn't see a thing. Then from inside the station, the screams began. The victim was one of their own. FBI Special Agent Robert Nightingale, gone missing here 13 years ago. Now he had suddenly turned up, only to be murdered in a brutal ritual on the very day of their arrival. And then there was the page. This page, the first page that they had found, not the last. The first step down into terrifying depths. Secret truths trembling beyond the threshold. Reading the words, these words, felt like a message. Was a message. Someone knew they were here, what they were doing. Someone playing a game with them, leading them on. An invitation. How could they not accept? The sheer audacity of this impossible mystery presented to them. Even if they knew it would end up hurting them.
Wake told me the clicker would fix this. But Wake was actually Scratch. How can I trust anything he said?
The artist must conclude his work. He rides a storm on your piece. Wake up and smell the danger. We told you already, kiddo. What Tom said about the light switch is true. Don't let the story confuse you. You need him to write the ending you want. The clicker can make that ending come true.
But we don't have Wake. Everything we knew about the clicker was true. He wasn't lying. Scratch told me the clicker can be used to change the story. Does that match your understanding of this thing?
Yeah, the light switch is a paranormal item, maybe even an object of power. We have verified reports that Alan Wake was in possession of it during the AWE here back in 2010. It definitely has power. We know that much.
I can come up with a plan. I always do. The clicker can fix this, but I can't use it without Wake. Tor knows about this stuff. Maybe he can help. Wake is still in the dark place. How do I get him out?
We live and breathe rock and roll. From the silence of screams, from the fever of dreams. The clicker can amp up other works of art, not just Tom's writing. Anything created with passion. The dark power of the lake will make it creep into reality. But if the holder of the clicker believes in the art, they can make it all come true in the flick of a switch.
I can use the clicker without Wake. Only Wake's writing can change the horror story. But I can use the clicker to change something else. Like getting Wake out of the dark place. I will use the clicker to change reality and bring Wake back at Cauldron Lake. I'll need the right work of art, but that won't be a problem. I've got it now. I just need to tell the others what to do and fix everything. For good. So we need Wake to fix the story, right? That hasn't changed. So here's what I have. Wake's still trapped in the dark place, under the lake. I think we can use the clicker to get him out. But first, we need a work of art. Something other than his story. And that'll get him here.
I'm not filling out the paperwork for this one. I wouldn't know where to start. But I'm sold.
Okay. Look, this feels like something that once we get the ball rolling, there's no turning back. You sure you have it all figured out?
Not just yet. Give me a moment.
Okay, Anderson. You let me know when you're ready.